Good afternoon to all of you. I hope you all are doing very well. In this section of my video, we will be going through a topic of drift velocity, which is a topic of chapter number 3, current electricity, class 12. Now, drift velocity is very important concept of current electricity. What do we mean by drift velocity? What actually drift velocity is? What are the considerations taken while we go through the logic of drift velocity is very important. As you all know that every metal consists of large number of free electrons. When the conductor is not applied to any battery or any external field, the motion of the free electrons of the conductor is random. Or you can say that the motion of the charges or the free electrons of the conductor is random or zigzag in such a way that their motion is such that the motion or the path of the free electron is random. Now, their path is such random that their average thermal velocity becomes zero. Now, how we are going to derive the concept of drift velocity, what actually drift velocity is, we will be going through an expression and getting an in-depth knowledge of drift velocity. Now, as you can observe that this is a conductor, this is a negative side and this is positive side, which means you have applied a field across this conductor. In the absence of field, that is when you have not applied this field, you can see that the motion of this electron, I have made a single free electron, the motion of this free electron is random. So it does not constitute to any current due to its random motion. As I said earlier, let us suppose that U1, U2, U3 till UN, if this conductor contains n number of electrons, be the random thermal velocities, then their average velocity, that is U1 plus U2 plus U3 upon n, will be zero. As I had explained previously that when no electric field is applied to the conductor, the motion of the free electrons is random, due to which the sum of their average thermal velocity becomes zero. This you have explained in the equation number 1. Moving to the next part of the derivation, let us suppose let E is the magnetic field that has been applied, as you can see in the figure. V is the potential difference developed on the application of electric field. Therefore, E equals to VYL, that is the field applied is potential per unit length. Now, when you apply this electric field in this conductor, the electrons in this region will experience a force due to which the electrons will get aligned in the direction opposite to that of field and will accelerate in the given direction. Therefore, the acceleration of each electron is A equals to minus E into capital E by M, where E represents the charge on electron. I had applied a negative sign here. This negative sign implies that the motion of electrons is opposite to that of the direction of applied electric field. This simply implies that the motion of free electrons is opposite to the motion of applied electric field. So, at any instant, if you observe that the electron is having a thermal velocity, this thermal velocity is gained by an electron on the application of electric field, which means that the electron was initially moving with the velocity U1. When you have applied an external electric field, the electrons get accelerated, and due to that acceleration, the electron achieves a thermal velocity, which is given as V1 is equals to U1 plus a tau 1. Now this tau 1 is relaxation time. I will explain in the later section what is this relaxation time. Now, remaining velocities of the remaining charged particles. Average velocity of the n electrons. Since a conductor contains large number of free electrons, we have Vd. This Vd represents average velocity of all the electrons. U1 plus a tau 1 plus U2 plus a tau 2 till the nth velocity divided by n. That is, we have to calculate the average velocity of all the free electrons. because when you apply electric field onto the conductor, all the free electrons will experience a force towards the positive end of the conductor, and the average velocity of all the electrons is known as drift velocity. That is why I have written average velocity of all electrons is Vd. Vd is the drift velocity. Now, simplifying this expression, U1 plus U2 plus U3 by n plus A tau 1 plus tau 2 till tau n by n. This portion is zero, as we have explained in the equation number 1. What do you get? Vd is equals to A tau. Now here, tau represents average relaxation time of all the particles. Substituting the value of A, we get Vd is equals to minus E into E tau by m. This is the expression of drift velocity. Now in this expression, you have gone through a concept, that is tau. We call this tau as relaxation time. What this relaxation time actually means, when this free electrons under the application of applied electric field start moving towards the positive end of the conductor, during their motion they collide with the walls of the conductor. So time elapsed between two successive collisions is known as relaxation time. Okay, I'm again saying time elapsed between two successive collision is known as relaxation time. So this was all about the logics, concepts of drift velocity. I hope you have learned this thing well. This is the final expression. Remember, this expression is very important. Thank you.